Now that I've added GPS to the radio, let's see how we can enhance the GPS throughput. By that I mean the number of GPS updates per minute that we can achieve on the channel. Now there are two ways we can do this. The first way is by using what we call enhanced GPS. So this is a feature in the radio and in the repeaters which basically coordinates the GPS updates. So instead of the radio sending a GPS update whenever it wants to or whenever an event is triggered, the radio now has a certain window period in which it should send its GPS update. The other way of enhancing GPS is to use single CSBK data. With single CSBK data, what we do is we compress the GPS update to a single CSBK message. So let's have a look at enhanced GPS in my code plug. So we have already configured the GPS revert channel. Now what we're going to do is we're going to enable enhanced GPS. So in the radio, what I need to do is I need to go here in the channel itself and I need to tick enhanced GPS. When I click on enhanced GPS, it brings up another field here that becomes ungrayed, and this is the window size. Now the window size you need to work out, and the way to work out the window size is to use the MOTOTRBO system design tool. The MOTOTRBO system design tool will allow you to work out the window size based on a certain number of GPS updates and a certain number of radios. The other thing that I need to do is I need to go and change some configuration in the repeater. In the repeater, in the channel, we need to go and tick slot 2 to have enhanced GPS. So ticking slot 2 tells the repeater that there will be GPS on slot 2, but this slot is used for enhanced GPS. So the repeater knows that it should send out the scheduling over this slot 2, so that the radios know that this is their slot. So the window size on the radio must match the window size on the repeater. And this periodic reservation window, this comes from the system design tool. The next thing that you need to decide is whether slot 2 will be used for GPS or data only, or it will be used for GPS and some voice. If you're going to be sending voice on slot 2 on this repeater, you need to tick this here. And what this does is it tells the repeater that this slot will be used for GPS updates, but it will also be used for voice. My recommendation is to try and keep the amount of voice on slot 2, if you have to use voice on slot 2, to keep it to the absolute minimum. And what this will do is it will ensure that the GPS updates are sent timeously. Remember that in MOTOTRBO, voice has priority over data. So if there is a voice call in progress, the data from the radio will wait. So it could mean that the dispatcher in the control room gets all of a sudden all kinds of GPS updates and then the long period where there are no GPS updates. The reason is that the channel is busy. If you can afford it, try not to send any voice through on a channel which is sending, particularly a channel which is sending a lot of GPS updates. Looking at the radio again, make sure that you enable enhanced GPS on all the channels which are used for sending GPS. So in our channel pool, site 1 GPS and site 2 GPS Both of them must have enhanced GPS ticked, and the window size must match that which is in the repeater. The other way that we can enhance the GPS throughput is to use single CSBK data. Now, to enable this feature in the radio, I need to go down into the channel and I need to select CSBK data. Ticking this will tell the radio that it should enable this feature, and the radio will attempt to compress the GPS update down to its bare elements. What this does is it significantly increases the amount of GPS updates that you can achieve on a radio channel. All that is required is to tick the CSBK data. So tick CSBK data on all the channels which are going to be sending GPS. And another thing that you are going to have to do is you're going to have to turn down the window size. The recommendation for using single CSBK and enhanced GPS is to have the window size set to 1.